Usually, satellites are put in a graveyard orbit and left to die, or shot out into space, or burned up in the atmosphere, but not this one! We're gonna save this one! Hey everyone, Trace here with your weekly space update from DNews. We've talked a lot about dead satellites and space junk, but this isn't a binary state. There are satellites in the middle, which are more like abandoned ones. They're not dead, they're not alive. We might just be able to bring one of them back. The International Sun-Earth Explorer 3, or IC-3, was launched in 1978 and placed at a libration point, or a Lagrangian point. Without getting too technical, the five L points are places in an orbit where gravity allows the satellites, rocks, or dust, to stay in a single spot as the Earth moves around the Sun. It's like a synced-up orbit. The IC-3 was put at a Sun-orbiting L point and left to measure plasma ejection, cosmic wind, and magnetic energy coming off of our star. A few years later, it was renamed International Cometary Explorer, or ICE, and tasked to be the very first satellite ever to meet a comet. NASA used the gravity of the Moon and the Earth to slingshot the satellite into the tail of a comet, beating the Russians, Europeans, and Japanese to the punch. And just because we've got a badass up over here, in 1986 it met up with another comet. You might have heard of it, Halley's Comet. After its triumphant success, the satellite kept on flying, studying coronal mass ejections on a 30-year orbit around the Sun. When it passed us again in 1997, NASA was all like, nah bro, we've got newer stuff to worry about, and the mission was retired. But now, a crowdfunded campaign to reboot the IC-3 is underway by private citizens. Their plan was to raise $125,000 and be able to contact the IC-3 and command it to fire its jets, placing it back in its original Lagrangian point. The team has already detected the communications from the satellite and hope to get help from the internet at large to fund and analyze the data that IC-3 is still capable of sending. Their crowdfunding campaign ended on Wednesday, and as of the time that we shot this video on Thursday, they've raised almost $150,000. They've got a power amplifier, they've got access to a radio telescope, and they are setting up a transmitter. NASA has approved their plan to contact and control the satellite, which is no longer in use to them, and now they just have until mid-June, until their window closes, to contact it and get it to do something, otherwise the satellite will disappear. It's kind of exciting. Assuming all goes well and they can contact IC-3, there is no way to know which instruments will be working after 3.5 decades in the harsh environment of space. NASA knows the transmitters were working and it had fuel in the tanks, but that's really all. It's been in hibernation mode for a long time, and electronics, they aren't magical. These people will have to find technology capable of contacting a satellite in its native language from the 1970s. Which, if you think about how much computers and wireless transmission has changed in that time, this is no small feat, and it's gotta be a big effort. Luckily, they've got a retired IC NASA engineer on their team, so that should help. The citizen scientists believe, if it works, they'll be able to put IC-3 back at the original Lagrangian point and resume study of space weather. Then, in the coming years, they plan to orchestrate a lunar flyby, followed by another comet meeting in 2018. This is the first time private citizens will have legally and actually acquired a NASA satellite, and it's gonna be the longest time a satellite's ever been dormant and restarted. Private science with government equipment, breaking records, this is just stellar. We've got comments for a reason, so get down there and leave some. And be sure you subscribe for more DNews. If you want to come say hi, find us at DNews on Twitter or pretty much anywhere else, or me at Trace Dominguez. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody. Y'all are great.